Hey, what's going on, everybody? It's your bro here. Hope you're doing well. And in this video, I'm going to teach you guys about the color chooser module in Python. So sit back, relax, and enjoy the show. If you find this video helpful, please remember to like, comment, and subscribe. Your support will help keep this channel running. Okay, everybody. So before we begin, we'll need a second import. So let's add this at the top. So from Tkinter, import color chooser. And the reason that we need a second import, and it's not included with this first import, is because this is a sub module. It's not necessary to add this comment. I just like to add comments for teaching purposes. So make sure you have these two imports before we begin. Now we'll need a window and a button that we can add to the window. And when we click on the button, we're going to select a color and change the background color of the window. So let's create a window. Window equals TK followed by window.mainloop. And then let's set the geometry. So we're going to change the background color of the window after we select a color. So let's select a fairly large size for a window, maybe 420 by 420. So this is the width and the height. And then let's create a button. So button equals button. Let's set some text. Text equals click me. And we're going to set a command for this button that is called. So we're going to create a function, maybe called click. And then we just need to pack this button so we can add this to the window. So button.pack. Now we're going to need to create a function and we'll call it click. So when we click on the button, this function is going to be called. So def click. And what do we want to do after clicking this button? What we're going to do is take color chooser. And we're going to use the askColor function. So currently this is what this does. We can select a color after clicking this button and pick whatever color you want. Then you hit OK. However, we need to store this color within, let's say, a variable. So we'll create a variable called color. Color equals colorchooser.askColor. And then we can do something with this color. But for now, let's just print this color just to take a look to see what it contains. So print color. So let's say that I want this green color. Click OK. This is what this prints. This is our color. So this is the RGB values that we have in this first element. So this is the amount of red, then green, and then blue. And the second element is the hexadecimal representation of these values. So what we want is this hexadecimal value. So what we could do is create a second variable to store this. So let's just call this color hex. Color hex equals color, and we're going to get the first element. Well, technically it's the second element, but it's the element at position one. So this one, this is zero, index zero. So we're going to basically extract this hexadecimal value, and let's just print this just to be sure that it's working fine. So print color hex. And let's try this again, but select a different color. Maybe I want this purple color, then click OK. So this is CB42FF, and here we have CB42FF. Now let's change the background color. So since we have this hex value, that's actually fairly simple. So we're going to take window.config, BG for background color, equals color hex. And this will change background color. And let's set this to a sky blue color. Maybe like this. Click OK, and it changes the color. However, it's not really necessary to continue printing these values. You can take these out if you want. And this would work like just the same then. Now, this part isn't necessary, but if you want, you can condense these three lines of code that we have for our click function into less lines of code. So what you could do, instead of assigning the value of color at index one to a separate variable, we can take color at index one, get rid of this line, and assign BG equals color at index one. So now this is done with just two lines of code. And why stop there? We can write this with just one line of code. So now we're going to take colorchooser.askcolor, get rid of this line, bg equals colorchooser.askcolor at index 1. And now this is done with just one line of code. However, it's I would say a little more difficult to teach. So that's why I kind of like to separate this line by line. So if you want, you can condense all of this into just one line of code. So here's some ideas of where the color chooser submodule could be helpful. So of course you can change the background color too, but let's say that you're creating a game and you can customize your character or avatar. Well, it would be kind of nice if you could have some way for the user to actually change maybe the character's hair color, eye color. Something like this would actually work fairly well. So yeah, that's the basics of color chooser. If you would like a copy of all this code, I'll post this in the comments down below. But that's the basics of color chooser in Python. Hey you. Yeah, I'm talking to you. If you learn something new, then you can help me help you in 3 easy steps by smashing that like button, drop a comment down below, and subscribe if you'd like to become a fellow bro.